And now, here's Wayne.
On a Tuesday, the 15th day of July, 2008. And coming up on our program, we're going to kind of change the order of the way we do things today because we have a special guest, and he's on a timeline that he needs to adhere to. And we're going to be talking with Jordan Wilhelm in a couple of moments and his fantastic story that he wants to relate to you. Just in part, because we can talk with Jordan for about 3 hours, but we'll kind of capsulize his heroic efforts in recovery from a very serious accident. And we'll be talking with Kelly Krein, too, and she's with the American Association of University Women, and their garden tour is coming up. But first, Jordan, welcome to our program, and I know that you're visiting Jamestown, former resident of Jamestown. You're born in Jamestown?
Yep, born and raised.
Okay. Can I get you just a little bit closer to that mic there, and we'll just move a little bit closer there? And Jordan, tell us a little bit about what you've been up to other than what we're going to be talking about. Now, you moved from Jamestown. You're living where now?
In Corona, California.
Okay.
So in Southern California.
Southern California. Okay. And you got involved in motocross.
Yep, correct. Motocross. So I was working actually since 13 to race for a living. So.
Oh, okay. So you're going to make this your vocation then?
Yep, that was my plan. And right before I got hurt, I was actually making money riding a motorcycle. So
you are.
I went from living the dream. So.
Okay, and you're active in a racing league type thing, or?
Yeah, it's kind of just a huge community, like through the whole U.S. It's kind of a huge community, so we're part of all that, and just trying to make it happen, trying to make a living out of it.
Mm-hmm. Now, explain for our viewers and listeners what kind of motorcycle you were riding, how big it is, and what kind of course we're talking about, too. We're not talking about just a circular asphalt track here.
No, correct. It's an actual motocross track with jumps and stuff like that. It's 450s, just big bikes, big motorcycles, so it's a...
So we're talking some huge two-wheel vehicles here.
Yeah. Definitely not, it's definitely different than the street bikes, but still big bikes. So.
And you're reaching speeds of how fast?
You know, like, they don't really relative as the speeds, you know, but, you know, you can go anywhere from 0 to 80 miles an hour. So, but you're definitely, you know, doing jumps, like two stories in there, big jumps, and, you know, it's just a huge adrenaline rush. It's one of those things where once you get addicted to it, you can never go back.
I bet, yeah. Now, when your accident occurred, were you in an actual race? Were you practicing, or what happened?
I was just practicing, actually. It's just at one of my local tracks in Southern California, and it was just kind of an accident, you know. Accidents happen, and everything happened right, and, you know, everything's meant to be, and this is what happened, so... Can't really dwell on that too much.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a very positive attitude, and I think that's helped you through the course of recovery. Now, when the accident happened, we won't dwell on the accident a lot, though, but I know that the story that's on YouTube from the hospital indicated that your mother got the call that you were hurt. Did you know how seriously you were hurt when the accident occurred?
I actually hit my head really hard, and I was actually out for probably about... a week and a half. They had induced me into a coma right there, so I actually don't remember the accident at all. So, you know, it's probably a good thing. You know,
yeah.
I just woke up in rehab, and the only thing I knew how to do was get better. So, you know, it's probably a good thing.
Now, when you woke up out of your coma, you were paralyzed.
Right. Correct.
And that basically from the chest down.
Yeah. From my chest down. So my stomach muscles couldn't work, so I couldn't sit up in bed or anything like that. So.
Okay. Now. When you woke up, you found out how serious your injuries were, what was the next step? What kind of surgery or surgeries, I would assume, occurred, and what was the diagnosis as to the seriousness of your injury?
Well, they had to go in and repair the area. There was a few broken bone fragments that they had to remove.
Now, we're talking about your spine, your backbone.
Yeah, and this is my spine. So they had to put a fake vertebrae in along with cages along the outside, seizing four discs so that it just support my back. And as far as my diagnosis, I was diagnosed a complete spinal cord injury, which means complete paralysis, meaning that you will not gain any function below the site of injury. So for me to be standing and walking with a cane, I'm beating the odds.
Absolutely. Now, were you quadriplegic or paraplegic?
No, the paraplegic, from nipples down.
All right, so the surgery in itself is amazing, the way that they were able to and I don't even know the technical terms, but if folks go to the YouTube link, they can, there's an interview with the doctor there as to what he did, how he did it, the surgical team, and that was in itself kind of a miracle in my estimation, because of the way that the injury was in your back and the way they repaired it. Now, with that said, we're talking about some major recovery. Now, this accident, by the way, happened about a year and a half ago.
Yep, it was January 27th of 2007.
All right, so we've had the surgery. You're in the hospital. Are you hospitalized for a long time, or were you able to kind of go home, come back, and do the rehab? Or?
Nope. I was full-time in the hospital for about 5 months, couldn't leave the hospital. And then once I went outpatient, I moved to a motorhome at a campground nearby. That way I could work out at the hospital every single day. So I didn't get home for probably about 8 months until I was solidly living at home. So, and this is like an hour and a half away from where I went to school and, you know, and where I live. So it was just me and my close family down here just doing work and just trying to get better. So
when you started rehab, did you have that positive attitude that you have today that you were going to beat the odds, you're going to get through this thing and you're going to walk again?
Yeah, I mean, for me, I think just, you have to, you know, like to get through anything in life, you have to have a positive attitude. And, you know, for me, I went from living the dream, riding a motorcycle, you know, this is just like, that doesn't happen, you know, you're going to be the living, to, you know, getting hurt. So the only thing I knew how to do was get better so I could race again. And, you know, I'm still doing that a year and 6 months later, you know, I'm just not there yet. So
now, as far as your recovery is concerned now, you walked into our studio with the aid of a cane. You weren't supposed to walk. You were, you know, be a paraplegic for the rest of your life. Now, you've gotten to this point now through positive attitude, through some good therapy, some good surgeons, and family support, I'm sure. Tell us about how your family backed you up.
Well, you know, without them, I would not be here. They are the backbone, really. They are my new back, you know.
Literally,
you know, and I think without family, you know, you can't do anything. And they're behind me 100% with whatever I do, whether it be, you know, getting better through this or wanting to get back to racing. They're supportive with everything. And, you know, I think that's what every kid needs, you know. I think that's what keeps kids out of trouble, and it keeps kids going on, you know, in the right direction. It keeps, you know, keeps me going, you know, mm-hmm. allows me to get better. So
is it your goal to actually race again sometime?
You know, I think that is my goal. I would say that, you know, once I started racing motorcycles, it's the only thing I wanted to do. And, you know, being that I was 17 and almost doing it for a living, I think the only thing I can say is I want to get better and I want to ride again, because, you know, there's nothing that compares to it.